Hello everybody, welcome to the Java course. It is quite usual for the programmer to accept some input from the keyboard. So in this video, I'm going to talk about this issue. We can accept input in the form of a string, an integer, or a double value. So how can we accept input from the user? We have to make use of the scanner class. So before we write the main program, we have to import the scanner class first. Okay, I simply type java.util.scanner. This is the scanner library that we are going to use when we want to accept input from the user. Okay, now we can make use of the scanner classes to accept input from the user. Okay, now I create a reference variable of a string. I'm going to accept the value coming from the user input by means of this string reference variable. So for now, no string has been created. And now I want to give a prompt to the user so that he or she knows what to input. Okay, I simply tell the user to use input the name. And this statement is going to create a scanner object from the scanner class. So scanString is a reference variable to a scanner object created by the new keyword. And here system.in means that I'm going to accept input from the keyboard. So how can I really accept the input from the keyboard? Let me do it now. Okay, I can use the next line method from the scanner class. So I want the scanner object to use the next line method, and the content obtained by the next line method from the keyboard will be having a reference stored in the user string variable. When the user presses the enter key, the string will be obtained by the scan object. So after I have got the user input, I can print the value received in this way. Okay, I can print out the string referenced by the user string variable. And after I have completed the user input, I can close the scanner object in this way. I can simply use the close method pertaining to the scanner class, okay? So when I have used the close method, the scanner object is no longer able to accept further input from the keyboard. So let me run it now. Okay, I just enter the name as, for example, Sam. Enter. And then the name received from the keyboard can be printed out. Your name is Sam. So when I have pressed the enter key, the object from the scanner class has stopped its further acceptance of further strings. So the string can be printed out when I want to. Okay. So we talked about inputting one line of string. How about the cases when we want to enter two or more lines of strings? We can have an arrangement in this way. Now I need to store two names, so I need two string references. I want you to enter your name and your dad's name. Okay, I simply create a scanner object whose reference variable is called scanName. So if I want to accept the first name, I simply use the next line method for the first time, and scanName.nextLine is going to help me capture the user input, and I'm going to put the string into name one. To be more precise, name one is a reference variable that points to the string object accepted or received from the keyboard. So if I want to accept another name, I can have similar idea. I simply do the next line method again so that the second name can be having a reference variable called name2. Okay, so when I press enter once, the first name will be received. When I press this enter key for the second time, the second name will be received. So I can print the strings out. Okay, here I just want to show the names of the people you entered. And after using the scan name object, I can close the scan object. Okay, let me see the result by running it. Suppose my first name to enter is Peter, and then I press enter. So now the first name has a reference variable called name1. Now I can enter another name, for example Nelson. So when I press the enter key for the second time, name2 will be pointing to the string containing Nelson, and then I simply print out the two names obtained from the keyboard input as usual. So this is a way to handle multiple inputs. And now I'm going to discuss the ways to accept integers from the keyboard. In fact, the idea is quite similar. Now I create two variables for the main method. And then I prompt the user to input two integers. Okay, I create a scanner object called scanNums, which is going to accept an input from the user. So we simply use the nextInt method coming from the scanner class when we want to accept integers. Okay, the integers obtained will be stored in the variable called int1. When I want to store another integer, I simply use the nextInt method again so that the first enter key would accept the first integer to be stored in int1, and the second enter key would simply allow the scanner object to accept another integer which will be stored in int2. Okay. After getting the two integers, I can make some arithmetic with them, and I can print a result of the addition of the two numbers obtained. Of course, I need to close the scanner object if I have used it completely. That means I don't want to enter further integers into the program. So let me save it and run it. The first integer can be 5. Enter. So now int1 will be having 5 as the value. The second integer can be 7. So when I press enter, this second integer will be stored in int2. And after pressing the enter twice, I would get the printing statement out, which is simply helping me to find out the sum of the two numbers of obtained from the keyboard. Okay. By the same token, we can accept double values from the keyboard. The idea is quite similar to the integer cases. I can simply change the int to double. Here I create a scanner object called scanDouble. And then I can make use of the next double method to obtain some double values from the keyboard. Okay, other parts of the code is quite similar to the previous example. So I simply turn int to double for my task here. So again, the code snippet is going to give the sum of the two double values obtained from the keyboard. Let me save it and run it. The first value can be 4.5, and for the next double method, we can accept some leading spaces and trailing spaces. Okay, this is an example of having leading spaces and trailing spaces. Enter. Okay, I'm going to accept the second double value. Suppose I don't give any leading spaces and trailing spaces. I want to have the sum of 4.5 plus 2.1. Enter. So the answer would be 6.6. So we can see that even though we have some leading spaces and trailing spaces, the next double method can help us simply obtain the values without considering the leading spaces and the trailing spaces. So this is the general idea of using the scanner objects from the scanner class. I hope you're able to understand the ways to accept strings or primitives. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, feel free to leave your comments on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.